and welcome to our 8th episode of this wonderful 2020-21 season of our video news, brought to you by yours truly at the SJHS News Crew. Please be aware that this is our last November episode, and we will not see you again until the first week of December following our Thanksgiving break. Whoa, did I just say December? We're approaching the final month of 2020. What a year. Well, I'm Ruben.
And I'm Lucas. Before we begin, let's stand, face the flag, and honor our country by saying the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you so much, and please be seated.
Let's see, what do we have for this week? Oh, here's an interesting fact. Did you know that today, 37 years ago, Adam Driver was born?
Wow, really?
Yep. Adam Driver, famous for his role as Kylo Ren, was in the recent Star Wars films, was born on November 19th, 1983. Oh, here's some more facts. Did you know that November 19th is also National Carbonated Beverage with Caffeine Day and National Play Monopoly Day? National Play Monopoly Day on November 19th recognizes the iconic board game that lands us on Park Place, Boardwalk, or even jail. Known as one of the most popular board games in the world, Monopoly was originally based on a board game designed by Elizabeth Maggie in 1902. Since then, the game has been played by an estimated 500 million people since 1935.
As mentioned earlier, Thanksgiving is dawning upon us. Thanksgiving Day is observed each year in the United States as on the fourth Thursday in November. Let's see what the Discovery Education has to say.
Turkey, mashed potatoes, and pumpkin pie. And take time to think about everything you're thankful for. It's Thanksgiving. In the United States, Thanksgiving is a federal holiday celebrated on the fourth Thursday in November. Thanksgiving began as a time of celebration to give thanks for a successful harvest and other good fortune throughout the year. Today, Americans observe Thanksgiving by enjoying the company of family and friends and sharing a large Thanksgiving meal. When most Americans think of Thanksgiving, they remember the pilgrims who arrived at Plymouth Rock aboard the Mayflower in 1620. The pilgrims were English colonists who left England in search of religious freedom in the New World. After a long and dangerous voyage across the Atlantic, the Mayflower arrived off the coast of present-day Massachusetts in November 1620. Most of the passengers remained aboard the Mayflower during the harsh New England winter. Disease spread on the ship, and half of the colonists did not survive the winter on the Mayflower. In the spring of 1621, the colonists went ashore to begin building the Plymouth Colony. With help of the local Wampanoag Native American tribe, the colonists planted New World crops like corn, beans, and squash, and learned to hunt and gather local food. Following a successful harvest in November 1621, William Bradford, the governor of the Plymouth Colony, declared that a Thanksgiving celebration was in order. Members of the Wampanoag tribe joined the Plymouth colonists for a three-day event that included hunting, competitions, religious ceremonies, and of course, a large feast. Unlike today, turkey was probably not on the menu for the first Thanksgiving. The Wampanoag brought venison, or deer meat, to share at the first feast. Waterfowl, like geese and ducks, and seafood like fish and oysters were common foods as well. Corn from the harvest and wild cranberries were also likely eaten.
Our news crew correspondents, Yusuf and I, thought it would be cool to go around and ask kids at lunch what they are thankful for.
I'm thankful for my family and everything that I have right now.
Yeah, I'm thankful for health, family, and friends. That's what I'm thankful for.
Family.
I'm thankful for my mom. I'm thankful for my friends.
I'm thankful for my friends and family.
What are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for this awesome school and the opportunity to learn.
I'm thankful for my Latin class because the teacher does a great job of making it a fun class and it's my favorite.
I'm thankful for my family.
Nice. I'm thankful for my family.
But I'm thankful for my friends. Happy Thanksgiving and stay COVID-19 safe with your families. Now we have some more club news. Boy Choir is open. If you like to perform and sing, or be in a part of a winning team, We had our first gathering last Thursday, November 12th. You still have a chance to join us on the 19th at 7:15 a.m. in room 105. Boys must come to one of these open rehearsals to solidify membership in the group. If you have any questions and or receive this message after the fact, please see Mr. Callahan or Mrs. Stein in room 105 or email them.
Another club starting back up is our Student Council. Are you interested in becoming a member of the SJHS Student Council? Student Council members will be asked to complete a variety of outreach activities and provide feedback for the betterment of our school environment. To apply, join our Google Classroom using the Google Classroom code 5BKDMFB. Again, that's 5BKDMFB to complete the application. Applicants are due November 16th, but hopefully you received this information in last week's episode. If not, please contact Mrs. DiOrio or Mrs. Wine to let them know.
Also, order your yearbook today before you forget over Thanksgiving break when the price increases.
Next, here's Ryan with his weekly sports update.
Hello, and welcome to the 7th edition of Ryan's Weekend Sports Prediction. We took a 1 week bye, but now it's your prediction time. The Bengals will battle the Washington football team this Sunday, and I predict the Bengals will get the win, 35-31. We have a top 10 battle in college football. The Ohio State Buckeyes will take on the Indiana Hoosiers. I hope the Hoosiers win, but I predict the Buckeyes will win 21-17. Those are all the predictions I have today, but you still can email sjhsnewscrew@sycamoreschools.org to make your very own predictions. This week's predictions must be in by November 20th at midnight. That is November 20th at midnight. That's it from me.
Well, I'll be going Indiana and Washington.
I'll just go Cincinnati and Ohio State, if they play this week.
Okay, now we have Clemens with his famous quote.
Welcome to Famous Quotes. This week's famous quote is from Albert Einstein. If you can't explain it to a six-year-old, you don't understand it yourself. That's it with your weekly famous quote, and I'll see you next time.
All right. That's a really good quote there, Clemens.
Let's go next to Gnor's fun fact of the week.
Whoa, I never thought that an eye could be that big. That's huge! And seems like an elephant's eye would be bigger.
Yeah, I didn't even know that was even possible.
We have our students of the week. Some other important information.
Alrighty, Sycamore, we have a special guest video this week from Brayden.
Like, help him across the building, like, to find a, like, class. And, like, before they can, like, get used to the building.
I would would tell them to go to the guidance counselor, and it'll help from there.
I would try to ask a friend of yours or somebody in the building or any teachers, and they would call me.
I will help them find their schedule and help them find their classes, so when they gotta go to their classes, they just know where they're at.
Those are great tips, Sycamore. Have a wonderful and safe Thanksgiving break, and we'll be back for the first week of December. I'm Ruben.
And I'm Lucas. Have a great 3-day weekend, and have a great Thanksgiving. And... Go A's!